Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will learn about the optocouplers. So we will see that what is optocoupler and how this optocoupler works. And then we will also see some of the applications of these optocouplers. And then after, we will see some of the important specifications of the optocoupler. So this optocoupler is also known as the optoisolator and the photocoupler. So this optocoupler is a circuit or the component which optically couples the signal of a one circuit to the other circuit. And since the two circuits are coupled optically, so electrically the two circuits are isolated and both circuits can have a different ground. So this optocoupler is very useful wherever we want to provide the electrical isolation between the two circuits. For example, when we want to couple a signal from the low voltage circuit to the high voltage circuit, then with the help of the optocoupler, it is possible to do that. Or in the case where we want to protect a very important low voltage circuit from the other circuit, which is prone to the high voltage spike and the noise, then the optocoupler can be used. So the optocoupler ensures that there is an electrical isolation between the two circuits. And with the electrical isolation, it is even possible to avoid the ground loops. So now, let us see what is inside this optocoupler. And let us understand how this optocoupler works. So on one side, it consists of an infrared LED or IR LED, which is made of a gallium arsenide. And on the other side, it consists of a light sensitive device, which detects the light which is emitted from the LED. So to optimize the coupling between the two elements, this LED and the photosensitive device are enclosed tightly in a single package. Moreover, their spectral response or the wavelengths are also tightly matched. So in this optocoupler, on the input side, this LED converts the electrical signal into the light signal, and on the output side, this photosensitive detector receives the light signal and converts it back into the electrical signal. So whenever the light falls on this photo detector, then the photo current gets generated. And in this case, this photo detector acts like a closed switch. And in a way, it allows the flow of current. And the same current also flows through the external load or the external device, which is connected with the photosensitive device. Now, in the absence of this electrical signal, the LED will remain in the off condition. And in this case, no photo current will get generated on the detector side. And therefore, this photosensitive device will act as an open circuit. And therefore, no current will flow through the external circuit on the output side. So in this way, with the help of the optocoupler, it is possible to optically couple the signal from one circuit to the other circuit. So in this way, with the help of the optocoupler, the low voltage circuit can be connected to the high voltage circuit, and yet they can be kept electrically isolated. Now if we talk about the optocoupler ICs, then this PC817 and this 4N25 are very well known general purpose optocoupler ICs. And in these optocoupler ICs, the photosensitive element is the phototransistor. But in general, in the optocoupler ICs, a photosensitive element could be a photo Darlington pair, a photo-SCR or even photo Triac. So depending on the application and the requirement, the optocouplers with the different photosensitive detectors can be used. For example, in the AC applications, the photo Triac or the photo-SCR based optocouplers are used. But in this video, we will only talk about the phototransistor based optocouplers. Now in these optocouplers, the input could be an analog signal or the digital signal. So similar to the normal transistor, for the digital input signal, the phototransistor is used in the saturation region, while for the analog signal, it is used in the linear or the active region. Now for the analog signal, even if we use the phototransistor in the active region, then also some sort of nonlinearity may appear in the output. Because in case of this optocoupler, the generated photocurrent is not linearly proportional to the LED optical power over the entire current range. So for such applications where high linearity is required, the linear optocouplers are readily available. So this type of linear photocoupler consists of two phototransistors. So the photocurrent which is generated in the reference phototransistor is used as a feedback signal. So the generated photocurrent in this reference phototransistor is used as a control signal to drive the LED. and in this way, it is ensured that the output photocurrent of the phototransistor is linearly proportional to the LED optical power. So depending on the usage and the application, various types of photocouplers are available. For example, for a fast switching application, the high-speed optocouplers are readily available. Or in applications where digital output is required, the optocoupler with the logic output can be used. So depending on the application, one should select a particular optocoupler. Now speaking about the applications, let us see some of the important applications of the photocoupler. So as I said, since the optocoupler provides the galvanic isolation, so in general, it can be used to provide the electrical isolation between the two circuits. Apart from that, it can be used to prevent a very important low voltage circuit from a voltage spike, noise, or even from the ground loop. Moreover, using the optocoupler, it is possible to control the high voltage circuit using the digital logic or the microcontroller. And yet, it is possible to maintain the electrical isolation between the two circuits. And they are extensively used in the communication system, in power supplies, as well as in the solid state relays. So these are the few applications of the optocoupler. Now let us see some of the important specifications of the optocoupler. Now in the datasheet, you will find many different specifications of the optocoupler. But here, I am going to discuss only some of the important specifications. So the first specification is the forward current and the forward voltage of the LED. So if you see the absolute maximum rating in the datasheet, then it mentions the maximum allowable value of the forward current. That means in the optocoupler IC, the current through the LED should be less than the maximum limit. And therefore, we should select the series resistor such that the forward current through the LED remains within the certain limit. Then the next is the forward voltage. So in the datasheet, at a particular current, the typical value of the forward voltage is mentioned. And with the help of this forward voltage, we can decide the value of the series resistor for the specific current. So let's say we want to control the LED with the microcontroller, and we want that in the on condition, the 5 mA current should flow through the LED. So now since we know the typical value of the forward voltage drop across the LED, so we can easily decide the required value of the series resistor. Now during all these design calculations, we should ensure that the source which is supplying the current to the LED should be able to provide that much of current. So if we are driving the LED through the microcontroller, then the source current of this microcontroller should be at least 30% or more than the designed current. So that is the forward current and the forward voltage of the LED. Then the next specification is the current transfer ratio or the CTR. So this current transfer ratio is the ratio of the output collector current to the input forward current of the LED. So the CTR or the current transfer ratio also changes with the photosensitive device. But for a given photosensitive device, it is a function of the temperature, the input forward current IF, as well as the output biasing voltage. And particularly, if we talk about the phototransistor based optocoupler, then it is the function of the temperature, the forward current and the voltage VCE. So typically in the datasheet, this CTR is mentioned at the particular forward current as well as at the particular voltage VCE. For example, in the given datasheet, this CTR is mentioned at the 10 mA forward current, and it is mentioned at the two different values of the VCE. One is when the transistor is operating in the linear or the active region, that means whenever the VCE is equal to 10 volt, and the second case is when the transistor is operating in the saturation region, where the VCE is equal to 0.4 volt. So apart from the CTR values, various curves for the CTR are also provided in the datasheet, which shows that how this current transfer ratio changes with the forward current, the ambient temperature, and with the VCE. So using these curves and the provided value of the CTR, we can decide the required output resistor as well as the biasing voltage. Then the next very important specification for the optocoupler is the switching characteristic. So in the switching characteristic, the typical rise time and the fall time of the optocoupler is mentioned. So with the help of the switching characteristic, we can decide the maximum operating frequency of the optocoupler up to which it works reliably. So for the high-speed switching applications, this characteristic is very important. Then the next very important specification is the isolation voltage. Now, typically, we say that the optocoupler provides the electrical isolation between the two circuits, but it provides this isolation up to certain voltage. So, typically for the optocoupler, this isolation voltage is specified in the kilovolts. So, here for a specific optocoupler IC, the different isolation voltages are mentioned at the various test condition. For example, for a specific optocoupler IC, here the isolation voltage is around 4.4 kilovolt and it can withstand that voltage up to 1 minute. On the other hand, if you see the maximum transient isolation voltage, then for the given optocoupler, it is equal to 10 kilovolt. That means it can withstand a transient voltage up to 10 kilovolt. So as far as the isolation and the safety of the circuit is concerned, then this is also very important specification for the optocoupler. Now when we talk about this isolation voltage, then we are assuming that the one side of the optocoupler is prone to the high voltage spikes. And if the high voltage spike or the noise arises on the one side of the circuit, then up to certain voltage level, it provides the electrical isolation between the two sides. But there are some noise which is common to the both sides of the circuit, which we call it as a common mode noise. So the optocoupler should be able to reject such common mode noise as well as the common mode transient noise. So this specification shows that up to what level the optocoupler is able to withstand such common mode transient noise. And typically it is mentioned in volt per microsecond. So these are some of the important specifications of the optocoupler. Now in the end, let us understand how these optocouplers are different from relay. So if you see the function of the relay, then it is also very similar to the optocoupler, right? Because this relay also provides the electrical isolation between the low voltage side and the high voltage side. Moreover, with the help of the relay, it is also possible to control the circuit on the high voltage side with the help of the low voltages. So in functionality wise, the relays are also very similar to the optocoupler. But these relays are typically slower than the optocouplers. The second difference is that the optocouplers are typically used for the low power applications, while the relays can work with high power and the high current loads. The third thing is that since the relays contains the mechanical part, so the lifespan of the relay is lower compared to the optocoupler. And unlike the relays, the optocouplers don't make any sound during the switching. So these are the some of the differences between the optocoupler and the relay. So in short, the relays are typically used in the high power applications, while the optocouplers are used in the fast switching as well as the low power applications. So that's it for this video, and I hope in this video you understood what is optocoupler, how it works, and what are some of the important specifications of the optocoupler. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.